commodity, a noun, defined as a useful or valuable thing. Definition given by humans who perceive value based on material, money, and bling. In a city which is glorified for its pure air and salubrious weather, oh, we shouldn't dare to think that converting every possible element of this city into a money-making scheme, giving those shameless companies a chance to redeem what rightfully belongs to every single being, especially the poor souls who clean up the dirt of the people whose rights of admission let them kill nature in every possible way, because we're paying for it, is all they have to say. Which is enough reason for those in power who kill the lakes, animals and trees to build a tower with billboards and advertisements and banners with bold lettered words that promote saving the Garden City and whatever remaining nature it beholds. Because it's never action, but only words we see, proving that this world is the epitome of hypocrisy. Natural and man-made water bodies, which were created all over the Garden City, diminish day by day with the help from a growing population who now wants to turn them into commodities. I'm sure the birds and fish are up for this. After all, their homes are as redundant as human piss. So go ahead and turn them into places of joy and play, because they'll rot there all day anyway. Oh, and while you're at it, throw your waste into their homes, it's fine. After all, it wouldn't cost you a dime. Big companies bought them, they'll take care of them, they claim, but we humans know it's just to give them a boost in their name. So many laws have been passed, ineffective as always, with the lakes diminishing every single day from the 1980s to right now, from 262 to 117 lakes, out of which only 33 are visible. But how can a population think of constant urbanization, using their supposedly educated minds to satisfy what they need, when there are people whose lives solely depend on these lakes, people who are constantly struggling to feed themselves and their children, and all they can do is fall to the ground and plead for help. And all the world does in return is give them a verbal apology. Because they know for a fact, and the fact is that, no one on this earth gives a rat's ass about problems that are not associated with themselves in any way. And in a world where money is the ultimate power, saving the lakes and the ones who depend on it is a far-fetched thought, because corruption enables these lakes to be bought by private constructors who build their own infrastructures without any consideration and worry for the souls whose life depends on these areas and have been illegally encroached upon. And now what? These lakes are gone, only to be replaced by commercial spaces and entertainment places and all kinds of money-making ventures, the only supposed form of development. But it all seems a little redundant, doesn't it? Oh, and it gets worse, I must add, because on all these lakes, all these infrastructures most definitely had a great role to play in the sewage, waste and rubbish display. Beautification and entertainment, defying the purpose of this natural work of art, created to naturally heal the ecosystem, which we brutally, shamefully and constantly tear apart. Day by day and night by night, they think they're making the place better, but they're only increasing the world's plight. Not just for the future, but the present and every moment in between, slowly constructing the destructions of the lakes that can now barely be seen. Thank you.